everybody, welcome to See or Not to See, and today we're going to be talking about Shock and Awe. The movie stars Woody Harrelson as Jonathan Landay and James Marsden as Warren Stovall, and they both give good performances in this movie. Everybody gives good performances in this movie. But let me just go into something that I wanted to explain real quick on how I judge these types of movies that cover these real-life events, like, you know, the way I judge The Post and Bridge of Spies, Spotlight, things like that. So I judge these movies on how many Hollywood moments and cliched moments are shoved into the story. Because these are true events, and they need to be done justice in a certain way. And if you cram too many Hollywood moments in there, it kind of ruins the movie and halts the flow, and it makes a lot of people doubt how accurate the movie is or how much justice it's doing. And sometimes movies can, you know, kind of, sometimes you need those kind of moments to kind of fill in some of the gaps, and some movies do it really well, others don't. This movie is a perfect example of shoehorning in too many of those moments. And when I say that, I mean that this movie rushes through a lot of details that should have been important. This is specifically important when you're covering a very heavy issue like this that's still affecting us to this day. You know, it's about our government lying to us and getting us into a war that we didn't need to be in and sacrificing thousands of men and women in uniform for a government agenda. You know, the government took advantage of our patriotism that we had after 9/11 to manipulate everybody into going into this war that we didn't need to go into. And disguising it as us going after Osama bin Laden. And it's a horrible event that's still affecting us to this day. And this movie doesn't do that event justice. They very much so, you know, cram a lot of things in this movie that didn't need to be in there. And one example is a pointless romance subplot that's in here that only serves a purpose for two scenes. And one of them is a very lazy, lazy exposition scene about how, like, this war is going to tear the country in half and cause civil war, which it did. And how, like, you know, people don't believe about, you know, that the government's lying to us, which it turns out that they were. They also bring up some points in this movie, like how our patriotism after 9/11 was kind of clouding us a little bit and leading to people making more rash decisions instead of, you know, rational, like taking a step back and thinking before we do these things, and how the government took advantage of that in a very bad way. And they touch upon that, but they don't do anything with it. And they do that with a lot of different kind of issues that were happening at the time that they really should have worked into this movie more. But for the good things in this movie, though, the acting was good all across the board, so I can't say anything bad about that. But there was just way too many cliches and things like that that drug this movie down. That's why I'm going to have to give Shock and Awe a not to see, because it doesn't do the source material justice. And I was disappointed having to give it that review. I really wanted to, you know, like this movie because I love, you know, history and things like that, and I love these types of movies, but unfortunately, like I said, it just didn't do the material justice. So that's it for me, guys. As always, if you like what you see, go and hit subscribe. You can follow me on Facebook and Twitter. The links are in the description below. Also, be sure to check out my website. The link is also in the description below. And remember, I waste my money so you don't have to. Thanks for watching.